I can't remember how old I was. Maybe I was about 5 or 6 or so. I remember dancing in a room with my mother, and she would play music in a cassette tape, you know, on a radio that's about this big and it was gray. And the amazing thing is that I never knew what I was listening to. And it was not until years later that I realized that what we listened to and danced together to was actually Mozart's Symphony number 40, the one in G minor. So in some ways, that education started really early without me even really realizing it. One of the things that I really valued about my parents is that they were very progressive. I mean, none of them were musical, none of my parents were musical, but they really valued the arts and they put us in music education, and that really started everything. And so when I was old enough, I was maybe around 6 or so, they felt like, okay, maybe it's time for you to do the same. And so that's kind of how I got started. As well as a teacher, I'm also a concert pianist, and so I perform in many different places and I perform internationally. One of the most significant venues that I played in is a solo recital in New York City and in Steinway Hall. Steinway Hall is the mecca for pianists, and so those are great experiences and have taken me to places that I otherwise wouldn't go to. Every student come to me with a different need. Sometimes the students come in and they can play with a lot of flair and panache, but then they really lack confidence on stage. And another student might have a lot of confidence, but lack the technical skills. So I try to give them whatever it is that they need for them to be a rounded, successful, and fluent performer. To be sensitive to the needs of your student, you have to have the knowledge, and you have to constantly better yourself.
Dr. Lim is amazing faculty. Not only is he a great teacher, which is very important for faculty, but he's also a great researcher, great performer. If you've heard him play, you know he has all the technical skills that you would expect and you would hope out of a great pianist, but he also brings every fiber of his being to the emotional part of the piece.
One thing you want to know about Dr. Lim is he's compassionate. He's a compassionate person. Well, now I'm going to say two things, and he's also passionate about what he does. He's always working to better himself and those around him. That was three things.
Passion comes from inside of me, you know, because, you know, one day when you realize or you decided that I want to be a musician or I want to be a performer, it really comes from a deep source within you. It's not sort of an intellectual decision and to say, oh, I think this would be a good idea for me to be a performer, or I think, oh, I'll look good on stage or something, you know? But it really comes from something deep within you, and I think that's something that I feel genuinely, and that's what I want to share with my students. I'm absolutely delighted for several reasons. The first being the fact that in the profession that I'm in, I feel that my work is never done, and I don't think I ever feel that I've arrived. And so, in this continuous journey that I'm on, I think it's a nice feeling to be noticed along the way. And I'm just very honored to be selected among my peers to receive this award.